What's on your mind? Cause you've been acting different lately, girl. What's on your mind?
What's up, y'all? It's your girl Jazzy from Jazzy's Playpen. Thank you so much for tuning in. This is the hub for all things beauty. There's lifestyle, dance, food, and so much more. Y'all, we talk about it here. Guess what I got for y'all? How to style a synthetic wig. Look, we have gotten so far from the old school wigs and the quick weaves and all that good stuff. We have traded that in for the frontals, the bundles, the units, the closures. Baby, we are spending no less than $200-$300 for our units. But sometimes, y'all, sometimes we have to get back to the old school way, and that's just pulling out a $50-$60 wig. So this wig cost me, if I'm not mistaken, I had it a couple of years ago. I think it was about $50 from my local beauty supply store. So it's a little matted and dry. But guess what? That's okay, because I'm showing you how to revamp a synthetic wig. So we're going to get right into it. I do not use a flat iron on my synthetic wigs. I use a blow dryer. Y'all, that's right, a blow dryer. All you need is a blow dryer, a round brush or a flat brush, and a comb to make sure that you are taking out those tangles. So I'm just going in and really taking my time to smooth out the hair, the fibers. This is not real hair. Synthetic hair is fibers. So anything dealing with a fiber, there's a tip for synthetic hair. To soften synthetic hair, you can saturate your hair in a little bit of fabric softener and water. That is to soften the fabric, soften the fibers of your wig, since this is not human hair. So I use a little bit of wig spray. It's for human and synthetic hair. That is what's in the green bottle. And I just used a little bit of Motion's Oil Sheen to make sure that my hair is very saturated with oil, so that once I blow dry, that heat can penetrate the fibers and make it really silky to prevent it from tangling, since it's been a couple of months since I worn this wig. So I'm just going to go right through to show you how to pretty much press a wig with a blow dryer and a round brush. So I like the straight look with the Chinese bangs, but I always go for some layers in the front with fringe bangs just to frame my face. So that's exactly what I did. I just kind of brushed out my wig again. As you can see, the texture has really smoothed out just from hitting the blow dryer and making sure that oil and this wig shine is on the wig. So I'm just combing, making sure that there isn't any knots, and brushing through just to kind of get an even cut in the front. So I just go from where I want the layers to start. I just really wanted to make sure that the hair was even across from each other. So that's exactly what I did. Guys, let me tell you something. Side note, I just want to let you guys know that you do not have to feel any type of way. Synthetic hair is still in, guys, and you really can't even tell once you style your wig correctly. So I'm just going in, guys, and getting those layers. You see where the first layer stopped, and then I just pretty much mat where I'm at. So you can see one side is longer than the other, so I'm just going to angle it with my shears and just go in to make my bangs even, and the layers in the front even, rather. So I'm just gonna go in, and normally I would start from up top where the Chinese bang is, but I don't want to create that mushroom bang or mushroom curtain layers, because it just depends on the look you're going for. So I started my layers a little bit lower this hairstyle. And guys, y'all know I got three boys, so y'all excuse me if you hear my babies in the background. I am a mom to pure, so you guys have to understand that kids does not stop the show. They just make sure that they are a part of it. So I'm just gonna go in the back, comb out. You guys see the end. I'm gonna go for the U-shaped cut. I love that cut instead of straight or blunt cut. So I'm just gonna go in and round my ends up as if I wore them, if I wore my wig downward, or down should I say, then it creates a nice U-shape cut in the back instead of straight across like some stylists, they cut straight across. But it just depends on the look you're going for, and there's nothing wrong with that. Sometimes it's hard to get your angle, especially when you're cutting your own hair. But as you can see, your girl was doing her thing, period. Yes, and then we're just gonna keep cutting and dusting the ends off. I think this wig is like a 30 inch. So if you wanna just, you know, be on your baddie look, your baddie-ish for an affordable price, get you a wig. Just get you a little nice little synthetic wig and learn how to put that thing on so that you can swing at an affordable rate. So I'm just gonna go in and cut straight across to which would be considered split ends, quotation mark, on real hair. But since it's synthetic, I just wanted to just get you in the mind to think how you would think cutting real hair or natural hair. So you're just going to angle a little bit and cut straight across to kind of give that even look once you finish cutting. Do me a favor, guys. Go ahead and like, comment, and subscribe if you like this content that I am putting out. I can't wait to see you guys soon on the next video. What's bye. On your mind?
'Cause you've been acting different lately, girl.